The YouTube Community tab is a new feature that is changing YouTube for the better. That's what we talk about today. Here we go! Hello and welcome back to another video. Now, if you're new around here and you're looking to start a YouTube channel, grow your YouTube channel, or push your brand out there onto the second largest search engine on the internet, click subscribe, start creating. From time to time, YouTube likes to upgrade its features and functionality. What that means is they'll retire some old features but give you new ones. So, over time, they trial them out with slightly larger YouTubers. Out of this kind of thinking pot, we've had previous things like the YouTube donations, which didn't work and went away. We got YouTube Red in America and Australia, but not in many other places around the world just yet. We had video replies, which used to be at the end, at the bottom of videos, where you could directly reply and put a video response, which worked really well, that they took away. But now, for YouTubers that are established, you can now get the YouTube Community tab, which effectively turns your old discussion area into your own almost Facebook feed-esque area in which you can post pictures, polls, and videos that feed directly into the subscription feed and user feed as just like any other published video. Now, before I dive deeper in how you can take advantage of this community feed, I want to know, have you used a community feed? Are you currently following a YouTuber that has a community feed that you feel is doing quite well? Do you engage in that? Do you take part in polls? Do you reply? Do you chat? Or do you think it's just another way to clutter up the video feed that you don't really watch anyway and you wish the old subs box was back? Please leave a comment down below. Okay, so the community tab on channels that have it is, as I said, it's an area to hang out with. It's kind of like social media platforming. It's a Facebook page, but on YouTube. It's got many of the features that you would expect from a Facebook group, but it's more centralized on YouTube. So instead of you pushing people from Facebook to YouTube, and then they go back from YouTube to Facebook to just be a community, you can now discuss with them your thoughts, your feelings, your actions in your own little news feed. You can create posts, you can upload pictures, or you can even link previous videos of your own or any video on YouTube into that feed. You can also create polls and stuff like that, so you can either get direct feedback on what content they want you to show. You know, would you like more tutorials? Would you like more tricks and tips? Would you like more deep diving into analytics? Those kind of things. Or on my Mr. Hairy Brit channel, I ask, what's your perfect roast dinner? Or how are you feeling today? How much turkey did you eat at Christmas? Now, the advantage of the community tab is pretty much self-explanatory. It's engagement. So if I'm uploading a picture and you're watching and seeing that picture and partaking in that picture and that poll and whatever else I'm posting there, I'm engaging you and I'm keeping you on YouTube and not on Facebook. What YouTube's trying to do is give YouTubers tools to keep you on their social media platform for as long as possible. So if I do post a daily poll, or if I do share Throwback Thursdays and here's a funny video, hopefully you get used to me posting that poll or those Throwback Thursday videos, and then you come back to YouTube for those, rather than going to Facebook for them. Because if you're on YouTube more than Facebook, you're possibly being served more adverts by YouTube, which is making YouTube more money. It also can help kickstart session time. So if 6 hours after I publish my YouTube video, I post on Mr. Hairy Brit, look, go and check out this hairy guy, that's pushing people from Mr. Hairy Brit over here. Or if I have my own community tab here, it's reminding you, oh, okay, this video's here, which can be very good for time zone changes. So if I publish in the morning, it's good for like my UK audience, but my US audience is in bed. But if I then post a funny reminder and post the video 6 to 8 hours later, my American audience is awake and my UK audience is going to bed, which can start session watch time, which can make them watch more YouTube videos or playlists. The more they're watching, the more your stats help, the more accrued watch time you're getting, the better channel authority you'll have, the higher your rank, the more views you get. It then becomes, once again, an ever-increasing positive feedback loop. Now, the sad thing for me is that this isn't a global feature. You cannot get this feature at this point in time unless you have 10,000 subscribers. And even then, they are currently slowly rolling out the feature to everyone over 10,000 subscribers. So, if you want your own community tab, it's one of those things that you're just going to have to strive for. Keep growing, don't give up, and you'll get there. But you don't have to have a community tab to have a community. Just engage people in your comment section. Yes, okay, you can't post pictures in your comment section, but you can ask them questions, you can post links to your next playlist, or you can suggest other creators. So you don't have to have the community tab to build a community. Just stay engaged, keep talking, be friendly, and when it's there, it's there. So I hope this helps explain what the YouTube community tab is and how you get it. For more tricks and tips, you know, download the free PDF up here or in the description down below. Remember to hit that subscribe button and the notification icon so you're alerted every time I upload a new video. Go out there, start creating.